Good morning. My name is Mohammed Ibrahim Babur, and I'm a commentary and university student in my second year of business marketing. I did my O-levels from LGS Phase 5, Lahore, Pakistan, and I did my A-levels from Into City, London, in 2019. And after completing that, I joined Coventry University. This is my video interview from 2004 Self-Employability Portfolio. In this video interview, I'll be applying for marketing placement at IBM. I'll be answering a few questions that I'm going to be asking myself that have been allotted to me by this assignment brief. So to start off with, the first question, why do you want to work for this company? IBM stands for International Business Machines Incorporation. It produces and sells computer software, hardware and middleware, and or provides hosting and consulting services for nanotechnology and from mainframe computers. It always facilitates innovation and people striving for innovation. It was founded in 1911 as a computing tabulating recording company. With slow yet steady growth, it became one of the largest companies in the world, with being the 19th largest in revenue earning, the 4th largest in market share and market capitalization, the 2nd largest in terms of strength, with more than 435,000 employees just in the USA. It became on to become one of the biggest companies of the century. Apart from this, it's no secret that the working environment that IBM provides is more of a family net environment, with people, employees, bosses looking, taking care of each other, loving each other, and that's a part of, and that's a work environment that I want to be a part of. Apart from IBM, the specific job position that it's offering me right now with the marketing placement, it requires a few skill sets. It requires advertising, marketing research, possible event management, possible website management, possible direct relations with the suppliers for new patents, and I am well equipped for all these. My degree at Coventry sets me up perfectly and beautifully in line with these skills. I know I can use them for the benefit of this company. And I know because it's an MTO, meaning it's under a senior officer's supervision, I believe that I can learn any skill set that I need to very quickly. Moving on to the next question. Give me an example of how you use your communication skills effectively. So I've always used to be an outspoken person, making people hear and know what I want and think. So last year in my second year, I was in a group presentation. I was grouped up with four exotic people. So it was a group of four people, including me, and the other three were exotic people, meaning one of them was from China, one of them was from India, and one of them was from Spain. All these three were not that well versed in English, and we had problem communicating from the start. From right off the bat, we weren't able to talk to each other. Like, I wasn't able to express anything that I felt because they didn't understand, and neither did they. So what the scene was that our professor assigned group leaders accordingly to every group, and we could not change it. We had to work with what we had. So we started working on the project, we started talking to each other, and we quickly realized that it's very hard. The Indian brethren spoke barely spoke English, the Indian brethren. The Latino brother, he's barely spoke English, only Spanish, and the Chinese, she was a girl, she only spoke Mandarin. So I was stuck in between. I opened up Google Translator from day one. I talked to everyone in their respective language, assigned parts, got to the bottom of it, didn't care about language barriers much, and we ended up scoring around 75-76% in that grade, which was pretty good because all of us came through, all of us talked to each other, even though using Google translators and everything, it was a problem, but our communication skills helped us through that. So the next question, give us a past example of when you were creative or did something new or different. So I used to work for Insaf Group of Chemicals, which is a wholesale dealer. It produces, manufactures and exports chemicals, such as adhesives for shoe soles, for car interiors, etc. So what I used to do was, I used to be a logistics store manager in their storefront in Shahalmi, which is the biggest market, wholesale market in Asia. There are a lot of low-cost laborers over there. There are a lot of people working to making a daily living who cannot afford to pay so much for a clean meal. Even the bosses, even the work, the business bosses that used to sit in the glass offices, they could not afford to pay so much for two meals a day. Because they want clean food. I noticed that there is no clean food over there. I noticed that the only food that you get is either street dirty food, like food that is unhygienic, that is not nice, that is not clean, that you would not even wish on your enemy, and paying high for that. And the low-cost wages had to eat that, and the bosses, they used to send their guy to bring food from around 2 kilometers away, which used to spend money, which used to spend important time, because in a market like that, you cannot waste that much time. I noticed this. What I did, because it was a family-run business, we had 10 to 12 mullahs of storage capacity just laying unused. What I did is I rented that place. I brought in kitchen equipment. I sent my home cook from my home to that place, who started making two meals a day. White rice with dal, a local food favorite in Pakistan, for lunch. White rice and chicken curry for dinner, which was hygienic, which was clean, which was cheap. And we ended up introducing that in boxes, and I used to go out to all of the offices in Shahalmi, distributing them for free for the first 2 days. People liked it so much, I ended up creating around 400 boxes a month. And I ended up selling around 400 boxes of meals every day for 60 days. Meaning that I was able to earn around 1 million PKR or above, which for that time was a lot. What I did with that 1 million PKR was that I saved up, I gave it to my mother, who in the end eventually used it on my tuition fees for the foundation that I did in Into City. It's not that big of a deal, but for a 17-year-old at that time, it was a huge deal. And still now, I will love to continue this business venture as soon as I go back to Pakistan. I had to leave it because I had to continue my education. And as soon as I go back, I know I'm going to be mass producing it and mass distributing it with a minimal range of profit. Next question. What relevant skills and experience can you bring to the role? So as I mentioned, my amazing 3 years in Coventry University set me up with the know-how of how to market research. I can efficiently research the market environment, the market players, the market vendors, and efficiently capture. Alongside this, I have a market vendors. I can research everything in the market. Alongside this, I have a well grasp of what people want. I can help in advertising and targeting and efficiently capturing a huge segment. I can be of utmost help in event organizing, as I have done many for my previous schools and months. Apart from this, I was a logistics store manager in Insaf. So I have previous experience with being able to work with people from all over and how to overcome the differences being efficiently and quickly, how to overcome the differences. Furthermore, I'm a quick learner and a hard worker, and this is an MTO program, meaning the direct supervision from the senior officer is going to help me a lot. I can pick up any skill, I can work hard and be dedicated to this company. The last question. What do you feel your biggest weakness is? How could we help you overcome it? Procrastination is my biggest weakness. I tend to leave the task that is allocated to me on the 11th hour. This is because I have no check on me. And I believe that till I get the work done in the time allotted, I'll be able to pass. What usually happens is I end up making silly mistakes in this. Because I tend to leave it to the last 11th hour, I mess up, I make silly mistakes, and I don't have time to revive it. So I end up getting low in situations where I could score high. So with the efficient team and with a set of hierarchy and with a proper structure such as an IBM, I believe I can manage myself perfectly. So two questions that you would like to ask the company. So the two questions that I would like to ask the company are, what recommendations do you have for pursuing professional development and advancement at this company? And lastly, what advancement opportunities are available? That's it. Thank you so much for your time.